problem 10. And what sum the money will the difference between simple interest and compound interest for 2 years at 5% per annum be equal to rupees 25? That is, the compound interest minus simple interest is equal to 25. So the given is n is given, n is equal to 2 years, n is 2 years, r is equal to 5%. The difference between compound interest and the simple interest, that is equal to 25. So what is the value of p? That is the question. Okay, so first we calculate the simple interest. Simple interest equal to PRT by 100. So P is the principal, R is rate of interest, T is a term. So this is equal to P into R. R is the rate of interest 5 into 2 divided by 100. So that is equal to P by 10. This is P by 10. This is the simple interest. And we know the compound interest. Compound interest is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 to the power N minus 1. So this is equal to P into 1 plus 5 divided by 100 to the power 2 minus 1. Okay. You simplify. This is the compound interest. Okay, compound interest is equal to P into 105 by 100 to the power 2 minus 1. Okay, so compound interest is equal to P into 105 by 100 to the power 2. 105 by 100 to the power 2 is equal to 1.1025 minus 1. Okay, so that is equal to compound interest is equal to P into, that is 1.1025. Okay, so the compound interest is P into 0.1025. So what is the simple interest? Simple interest is 1 by 10, that is 0.1 into P. What is the compound interest? P into 0.1025 minus 0.1 into 0.1 into P. Okay, that is equal to 25. Okay, rupees 25. So here P is common. We take it out, 0.1025 minus 0.1, that is equal to 25. So P into 0.1025 minus 0.1, that is equal to 2.5 into 10 power minus 3, that is equal to 25. P is equal to 25 divided by 2.5 into 10 power minus 3, that is equal to 25 into 10 power 3 divided by 2.5. So P is equal to 25,000 divided by 2.5. So 25,000 divided by 25, so 2.5, that is equal to 10,000 rupees, 10,000. So the P value is rupees 10,000. So that's, this is the answer. Then the difference between the simple interest and compound interest for 2 years at 5% per annum equal to 25, and P is 10,000 rupees. This way you have to work out this problem. The next problem, the difference between the compound interest and the simple interest on rupees 8400 for 2 years is rupees 21. at the same rate of interest per year. So the compound interest and the simple interest is same. Find the rate of interest, find the value of R, that is the question. Okay, here P value is given. P is equal to 8400. Okay, N is given, N is equal to 2 years. It is given, 2 years. And the difference between compound interest and the simple interest, that is equal to rupees 21. So we have to find what is the value of R. Okay, first we calculate simple interest. Simple interest is equal to P into R into T divided by 100. So P is equal to 8400 and R we don't know, T is 2 divided by 100. So this is 168 into R. So this is the simple interest, 168 into R. So this is the simple interest. Next we go for a compound interest. Compound interest is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 to the power N minus 1. Okay. So compound interest is equal to 8400 into 1 plus R. R we don't know. Divided by 100 to the power 2 minus 1. Okay. So this is again I simplified. Compound interest is equal to 8400 into 1 plus 1 by 0.01 to the power 2 minus 1. Okay. 1 by, so 1 by 100, that is 0.01. 1 point, so that is equal to, compound interest is equal to 8, that is R by, this is R, sorry, this is 0.01 into R the whole square. So this is A plus B. So this is A plus B, the whole square formula. So A square plus B square plus 2AB. So this is 8400 A square 1 plus B square 0.01 R the whole square plus 2 into 0.01 R minus 1. Okay. So A square B square plus 2AB. Okay. So this will become compound interest is equal to 8400 1 plus 0.01 R square. 0.01 square. So 1 into 10 power minus 4 R square plus 0.02 R minus 1. Okay, this one get cancelled. We'll get a compound interest is equal to 8400 into 1 into 10 power minus 4 into R square plus 0.02 R. Okay, so this will become about 8400 into 10 power minus 4. This is 0.84 R square plus 8400 into 0.02, that is equal to 168 R. So this is the value, final value. So the compound interest is equal to this value. So simple interest is 168 R. Okay. Compound interest minus simple interest. That is equal to 0.84 R² plus 168 R minus 168 R. So these two terms get cancelled. So this value is given. This value is rupees 21. 21 is equal to 0.84 R². So 21 divided by 0.84, that is equal to R². So 21 divided by 0.84, that is equal to 25. R square is equal to 25. R is equal to 5%. The rate of interest is 5%. So this is the answer. This way you have to work out this problem. If rate of interest is 5% and P value is 8400, the difference between compound interest and the simple interest is 21 rupees.